Before we start the day, just a short recap of what we have yesterday. On the second day, I was looking at the missing layers of MSP. So today, yesterday, we have five speakers in an interrupting session on decolonizing science. The first speaker was Priscilla Lopez. Priscilla gave us a super interesting presentation on bridging the gap between dominant economic rhetoric and marine expansion planning and the factor social ecological system approach. Priscilla spoke, for instance, of which social goals were important and for who, and spoke about transformation and three important aspects of it, which were recognitional justice, procedural justice, and distributional justice. And also presented the concept of blue degrowth and a framework for just aquatic governance. The second presentation was from Chanta Chansunahar on saving lives and engaging fisheries. Citizen science in MSP in Bangladesh. They've been doing amazing work in the Bay of Bengal, where there are many endangered species. And they've been working with the fishermen and providing them with training and with different equipment so then they can collect their own data. And this data has been used to support marine spatial planning and to set protected areas in Bangladesh. Our third speaker was Kiragi. And her presentation was on culturally significant areas and the way forward. Kira spoke, and mentioned something that I took from the presentation between many things was that marine spatial planning is about choices. And she said that one key message that she wanted people to get from her presentation is which areas or which values are most important and must be kept for the communities that values them. Our first presentation was from Marlene Brito-Millan on ocean grabbing. And Marlene presented the concepts of ocean grabbing and environmental justice and resurgence from a decolonized autonomous life force. Our fourth presentation was from Guillermo Ortuño Crespo on considering indigenous people and local communities in the governance of the global ocean commons. And Guillermo presented information and the summaries of information from the whole world and the lack of data that is on the economic exclusive zones and the high seas and how this presents a barrier or a roadblock to implement a cross-sectoral management in the high seas. Our last activity was a super interesting interactive session on a call to defiance and tools for the colonial feminist science. And this was super interesting and very interactive, and I think opened the eyes of many of us on that attended the presentation. And this was given from the Center for Interdisciplinary Environmental Justice. So today we also have very interesting presentations lined up, and the first one will be from Karen Alexander, Marine Spatial Planning and Governance in MSP. Then we will have four other presentations, and then we'll have a break and we'll have the flash talks from the early career researchers.